Okay, so we are going to start at problem one. I have written a statement down here on this window. We have positive integers a0, a1 up to a3030, and they satisfy the relation 2a n plus 2 equals a n plus 1 plus 4an. I have denoted this formula with a star so that we can refer to it later. And this holds for all n from 0 up to 3028, which is all n for which the equation actually makes sense. We have to prove that for some of these n's, at least one of them, a n is divisible by 2 to the power of 2020. This is a bit of a strange looking problem because we have some sequence, it satisfies some constraints, and then somehow it has to be divisible by this huge number. So I wouldn't really know where to start, so we are just going to start by plugging in some small numbers. We know from this formula that if a0 and a1 are known, then we can calculate a2 and then a3, etc. Since the ai are supposed to be positive integers, we are just going to start by the simplest example. a0 is 1 and a1 is 1. And we will see what happens. Plugging in n is 0 will give 2a2 equals 1 plus 4 is 5. So now we already get a contradiction. Very sad. So this was actually not a valid way to start with the sequence, I guess. So where did we go wrong? We can't divide by 2 here. So I guess if you put n as 0, we can conclude from the formula actually directly that a1 should be even, otherwise it will not work. So let's write that down, a1 even. Then we can make our next example. Second easiest example would be a0 is 1 and a1 equals 2. In this case we would get 2a2 equals 2 plus 4 is 6, so a2 is 3. Okay, so we already have 3 terms in our sequence, amazing. Then we can go on to calculate a3. We get 2a3 equals a2 is 3 plus 4 times a1, so that would be 8. Oh, so now we get 2a3 is 11, but this is a contradiction again. The way this goes wrong is similar to the way it went wrong before. We now have that a2 should also be even, otherwise a3 will not be defined. So this is already kind of an interesting thing, because we want to have so many factors of 2, and now we already found that some of these numbers have one factor 2. So maybe we can write down what we found, because this kind of generalizes. If you look at the formula star above, we actually see that a n plus 1 must be even. But be careful, this does not hold for all n, only for the n in this sequence. So for n between 0 and 3028. So another way to formulate this is of course that a n is even. For n at least 1 and at most 3029. Okay, so this is what we have proven now. So let's put a box around it. What went wrong here? A2 must be even, and if you go back to step 1, so step 1 was a2 is a1 plus 4a0. If we want a2 to be even, then actually a1 must be divisible by 4. And that is why it went wrong in our example, because a1 is just 2 here. You must have 4 is a divisor of a1, this is written like this. Okay. Alright, so maybe we can make an example where this is actually true. I will erase this now, but just remember the formulas, okay? Okay, apparently we want A1 to be divisible by 4, so we will do that now. A1 is 4. And then we have 2A2 equals 4 plus 4. So A2 equals 4 as well. Very nice. And then we can calculate A3. 2A3 equals 4 plus 16 is 20. So A3 is 10. Alright, then we can go on to the next one. 2A4 equals 10 plus 16 equals 26. And A4 equals 13. Ah, but now we have an odd number, and now we already know that's going to go wrong in the next step. So apparently this way of making sequences does not really work, but we have already found some interesting things from it. Namely that many numbers are divisible by 2, and A1 is actually divisible by 4. So this last thing is maybe something that we can generalize. So if we look at the general formula again, 2a n plus 2 equals a n plus 1 plus 4an. And now we know that we already know that this is even. A n plus 2 is even. At least when we have not it for all n, because for n is 3028, it may just go wrong, but if n is between 0 and 3027, then we know this, okay. And in that case, this is divisible by 4, and this is also divisible by 4. So we know that an plus 1 is divisible by 4. For n between 0 and 3027. Or another way to say it is to say an is divisible by 4, and then we do here one more. Alright, so I'm going to make a drawing now of what we have. It will be very nice. Here are our numbers, A0, A1, up to A3030. This is going to be a graph, and on the y-axis we are going to put the number of factors of 2. So it's at least divisible by 1, it might be divisible by 2, 4, 8, 16, etc. So since they are integers, we know that if you put here the number of factors of 2 of each number, is always at least 0. And we have shown before that between 1 and 3029, let's put some more numbers here, that it is divisible by 2. So we know that it is above this line. And after that, we have shown that between 1 and 3028, it's actually divisible by 4. So the number of factors 2 is above this line. Alright. Now we are going to continue from here. So again, look at the formula. 2an plus 2 equals an plus 4an plus 1. And now we assume that all of these numbers are between 1 and 3028. In that case, these numbers are all divisible by 4. So we can actually see that this left-hand side is divisible by 8. And this term is also divisible by 16, so also by 8. So we have AN should also be divisible by 8. This is wrong, sorry. AN plus 1 should also be divisible by 8. And this is for N between 1 and 3028. Or if we change the variable, AN is divisible by 8 for N between 2. This doesn't make sense. Hold on just a minute. We know that, yes, okay, so these numbers are between 1 and 3028. We take N between 1 and 3026. Okay, yes. Because also AN plus 2 should still be within this layer, okay? So 8 is the divisor of AN plus 1 for 1 smaller than N smaller than 3026. Or also you can say AN is divisible by 8 for N between 2 and 3027. So this means that we can build another layer on our cake between 2 and, yes, it would be A3027. And now we get a very nice looking cake already. And if you continue in this way, you get smaller layers, and you see each time that on the left-hand side, it's kind of... 2 at a time, and on the right hand side is 1 at a time, like this. So now we have kind of a conjecture how our cake is going to look like. And this is something that we should prove by induction. And this will not be very hard as soon as we write down explicitly in formulas what this cake means. So if k is the height of some layer, so let's say k is here somewhere, then the left hand side of this cake would be about k over 2, and for example if the k is 1 it would be 1, k is 2 it would be still 1, k is 3 it would be 2, so it should be k over 2 but rounded up. And on the right hand side it's just 3030 minus k. So the statement would be for all n between k over 2 rounded up, it's written like this, and 3030 minus k, we have AN is divisible by 2 to the power of k. Alright. So we're going to prove this by induction, of course. The case k is 0 is clear because everything is divisible by 1. The case k is 1 we also need because it's going to be a two-step induction. If you take k as 1, we get for n between 1 and 3029, the number is divisible by 2. This is what we proved on the first page. So now we can do the induction step. And for the induction step, we're going to suppose that it is true for k and also for k minus 1. So unfortunately, I will have to erase this beautiful cake now. Alright, so we want to prove the statement for k plus 1, so let n between k plus 1 over 2 and 3030 minus k plus 1. And we are going to apply the formula for an, so we are going to change variables, just one lower. 2an plus 1 equals an plus 4an minus 1. This is what we know from star. And now we have some bounds on n plus 1 and n minus 1. So we have n plus 1 is at most 3030 minus k. And of course, it's still at least k over 2, because this is just a weaker bound than what we have here. This is plus 1 on this side and minus 1/2 on this side. So it's going to be fine. And then here we use the induction hypothesis to conclude that an plus 1 is divisible by 2 to the power of k. N minus 1 we can also estimate, but now we have to change this k plus 1 to k minus 1, because it's divided by 2. Now k minus 1 over 2, if you round it up, it's just k plus 1 over 2 rounded up minus 1, because the rounding kind of commutes with that. And of course this is less than 3030 minus k minus 1, so we can use the induction hypothesis and conclude that an minus 1 is divisible by 2 to the power of k minus 1. Now if you look at this formula again, we see that this left hand side is divisible by 2 to the power of k plus 1. So 2 to k plus 1 is divisible by 2an plus 1. And also, since we have a factor of 4 here, we get 2 to the k plus 1 is also a divisor of 4an minus 1. And you conclude that an is divisible by 2 to the power of k plus 1. This finishes our induction. So we can complete our cake all the way to the top. And now the only thing that is left is to put k is 2020 and see what the statement says. It says that for n between 1010 and 1010, this will be exactly one number, we have an is divisible by 2 to the power of 2020. And then we are done. Thanks for watching. And leave a like and please... what do they always say?
Subscribe.
Subscribe so that you never miss another solution on this window.